are likely to bite you because I won't be standing at the fence like this with them.
Okay. I didn't know, like.
Yeah, no, Nicky's pretty good. I'm starting to have a pretty good level of trust with him. He's kind of the farm busybody. He has to know everybody's business, what's going on, when.
Says,
and, you know, he looks so much like his brother who won the Derby, too. That's the amazing thing.
He has not been in the Derby?
Or no, he was never good enough for that, but his big brother won it.
He's good enough.
Oh, you found a good spot. He's liking that. Look at that lip coming out. Look at that lip.
Laura, we're going to be...
Barbaro's actually buried in Churchill Downs.
I understand. I heard a little bit about this. I don't know if you can
He's like, oh, give it back. Just keep your hand flat. You won't be able to
like
this.
I was trying to get a boomerang.
I thought he was just cremated.
I'll do it for you.
Oh, is that the statue there?
Do you want to be in it?
Oh, the statue. I think that he's just been cremated. Anymore, they cremate horses, so... Yeah, that's been kind of, they haven't done the head, heart, and hooves for years.
Oh, they don't do that anymore?
No, it's cremation.
Because
they're like the state of Kentucky, if a horse has to go out for lab, you know, necropsies, they're not allowed to bring back the entire body. Claiborne was so upset about that when Pulpit died, because they always buried the full body for their special horses, and they had to cremate.
Yeah,
and that's what we do a lot of times.
Head, hooves, and heart.
Yeah, that's what it used to be, but that's been, that's an old fashioned. Good thing. Nikki, you are such a ham. There's the itchy spot.
Yep.
This is so beautiful.
Yeah. He's like, I want more.
Well, you want them.
The boomerang.
Yeah.
So
beautiful.
He's such a good first tour horse because he's so nice. Used to, we have Sarava, and Sarava, depending on the weather, would either bite you or love you.
Is that fine? I can redo it.
Anyway, we'll come on up here because I don't want to keep y'all all day. We have more horses to visit.
This is Roosevelt with Otto and Edward.
All the Canadians who've moved into Kentucky over there.
Horse farm. We'll be taking a tour. I don't know how long it'll last, but I'll be here as long as it does. This is a part of the Toyota Bluegrass Tour. This is day number 3. From here we go to Churchill Downs for the balance of the day. But this is the old friends thoroughbred horse farm. This is where old thoroughbreds are retired, basically. And they're taking...
It's a non-stop effort to fix fences.
Yeah.
Like we put some new posts in.
How big is this place?
I think we're up to about 240 acres. We actually go all the way down to Ironworks over there, which is where the traffic light is.
Yeah, it's awesome.
And we go back up a ways too.
And how many people take care of this?
There's probably about a dozen people working on farm maintenance and horse care. And we're kind of on a shoestring because you can't find people to work anymore.
Everybody wants to work at Toyota.
Yeah.
It's true. So I guess I would want to work at Toyota.
You better come see this guy now. He can do it again.
We'll see him first. They tracked all the girls.
She just don't stay close. Oh, what a pretty picture that would be. Yeah. Oh, well, he's already moved.
Oh, no.
Yeah, the photographer in me is always looking at... I do most of the social media photos for the farm. Hi, Sun King.
There's a social media of the farm?
Well, we have a Twitter page and a Facebook page, so, you know, we'll try
to
do the basics.
You
and
then,
How beautiful.
Sun King.
Yeah, I think we're at Old Friends Farm on Twitter.
Okay.
Now this guy can be a bit nippier, so you can give him carrots, but I wouldn't hang close afterwards. Notice I'm not leaning on the fence today on this group.
I'm gonna risk it, buddy.
He's ready.
I know.
There you go.
Yeah, I mean, he's relatively nice. He's not just going to go for people, but he wants carrots.
He's like, I'm going
to
get.
And he was a stallion until late in life, so he's got a stallion mentality. They don't like to be pet on the face.
Oh, really?
Because they think you're trying to get on. Oh, okay. To them, going at him like that is trying to dominate him. So to a stallion, I'm the boss. I'm the stud. So, you know, that's how he thinks.
Bud.
This is Sun King. He was a stallion until late in life. He was gelded when he was down at the Auburn Vet School towards the end of his breeding career. So he can be a little nippy, so I wouldn't just go up and put my arms around him, but you can give him carrots. He's quite happy to get carrots. Remember I mentioned a horse named Charismatic who's buried up in the cemetery? This was his best son on the racetrack. He earned a little over $2 million, won the Pennsylvania Derby and a few other nice races. He was an okay sire, and then obviously not a great one, or he wouldn't have been sent to the vet school and then gelded later in life. He arrived at Old Friends a week after his daddy died, so it was kind of bittersweet for us to be getting Sun King.
He's like,
yeah. Yeah. You have a lot to say, don't you? No one's feeding you, though, because I told them you weren't always nice. Go figure. But if you want to meet something nice, if you turn around and look behind you.
How much longer are you already gnawing on the wood?
This is our $10 million paddock.
Oh, yeah.
This guy can have as many carrots as he wants. Yeah. The other one can have a total of 2 pieces of carrot. He's on a restricted
diet.
Here, I'll get his 2 pieces. What's funny, these two horses here between them earned upwards of $10 million on the racetrack.
What?
Feel free to grab carrots and feed Mikey here. They never won a championship. Little Mike here was a really good horse on the turf, the grass, running on it. He earned over $3.7 million doing it. They're not feeding you, are they, Mikey? What is wrong with this picture? The problem with little Mike's career is he was running the same year as a horse named Wise Dan. And Wise Dan was also a turf horse who was very popular, and he ended up earning the championships the year. This guy actually won the Arlington Million, the Breeders' Cup Turf. He is a really good racehorse. His buddy over here, who is the sweetest horse on the farm, you can kiss him on the nose if you want some photo ops. Hey! What? See how he's just bumping me with his nose, though. That's good manners. He used to be kind of not nice about getting carrots, but since he's been with the dude, he's really calmed down. The guy up here is Game On Dude. He was owned in part by Joe Torre.
I want a picture. Don't go.
He actually had, and I don't know who his ownership partnership was, but the Silks had a big basketball on the back, so there must be someone in basketball involved, too.
Did you get it?
But he was trained by Bob Baffer. Earned $6.3 million on the track. He's the only 3-time winner of the Santa Anita Handicap. If you've ever seen the movie Seabiscuit, there was one race that they wanted to win more than anything else, and it was the big cap. Here's a 3-time winner.
Wow.
Hey, dude. See how sweet this horse is? Jill Baffert, who is the wife of the trainer, loves this horse. She loves him. Bob actually quipped that he was kind of glad to see Dude leave when he retired because it meant he gets to spend time with his wife again. But Dude here had colic surgery, yes, I know, a couple of years ago, and he so we kind of limit his carrot intake as a result. There's like 4 more tours coming, Dude. You're going to get carrots, don't worry. But he is just so, both of these guys are just so darn sweet, you know. Mikey has really taken after the dude and learned to be nicer.
I got a photo, but you want me to take a lot?
Yeah. Yeah, here, let's grab a couple of carrots and he'll be happier.
Aw, buddy.
But these guys are really good about. Now, what he's doing there is something called cribbing. It's a habit a lot of horses get into on the track. He's just like belching, if you will. It supposedly releases endorphins and makes them feel kind of high.
Self-medicate.
Yeah.
Come on.
He says carrots. Carrots. Give me a carrot.
Right, all right.
That bucket's supposed to be empty by the end of the tour.
Yeah, there are a lot.
They're kind of a little.
Yeah, I can see that's the right.
Look like they like to wallow in the mud.
Mikey, you're so muddy. How can I send muddy photos to your people? how, I asked you how.
Do they roll around much?
So many issues.
What's
we
up, buddy?
We gotta figure out what's going on.
What are you doing, huh?
I mean, we do have one for the horse on the farm and a couple of minis, but...
So those are all thoroughbred stallions?
Yeah, actually, well, Sun King was a stallion. We haven't met any stallions yet, have we? Nicanor was a stallion at one point, but they've both been gelded, so...
What's gelding?
Gelding, I like to call it brain surgery. It's also called castration.
Yeah. Brain surgery. Spoken like a female.
How long can they stay? It just depends on the horse.
You know, Mr. Prospector was still covering mares when he was 29.
Wow.
So think about like a 100-year-old man being able to get it up and do the deed. Usually by the time they get into their early 20s, their fertility will start dropping, and by 25 or so, they're done usually.
Okay.
The really, really good super sires, they will try to get every ounce of, well, anyway.
Tell me again. Come on, guys.
So it's a special combination of their talent and their ability to have their second career.
Yeah, yeah.
Not all the best racers are good sires.
You the video.
No, no.
You up.
Sometimes it's an obscurely bred horse who jumps up. But they usually don't get the opportunity to become a good sire.
I mean, I use
so when they do, it's really amazing.
I only do my blog now. It's too much to do both.
Yeah, I know. I agree.
And that hill's the hardest part of the tour. I swear.
From what I understand, I don't know if you can tell me if this is true or not, the ones that are really expensive, there has to be like a... like a viewing party to make sure things actually happen.
Oh, every cover is filmed and everything now. Just to show that, yes, your mare saw the right horse.
Yeah.
Because there's a lot of money involved.
No pressure involved for the horse.
Yeah.
So what does that mean when that horse was stomping back there?
Flies. He was trying to stomp flies off his leg.
Oh.
Well, stop here and say hi to the little guy. He can't have ferrets.
Oops.
So. I said we had a couple of horses who weren't thoroughbreds here.
This is one.
Yes.
Mighty Mike. Thoroughbred.
No, he's on the diet.
I just call him Mighty Mike. He's a thoroughbred.
How old?
At least 32, 33. I'm out of shape for that hill tipping out. This is bad. I walked a 5K last Saturday, though, so. As Nick's last finisher by 0.7 seconds, but me and a friend walked it. We got a funnel cake at the end. It's called funnel cake. Sometimes that catchy name is what draws the people in, you know.
Go ahead.
This is Little Silver Charm. He's kind of our farm mascot. He's actually the spokes horse for the Scott County Tourism Commission. If you look at the Georgetown folder flyer we have up in the office, he's on every single page imparting wisdom about what to do around Georgetown, Scott County. He was actually found on one of those trucks that pulled into the racetrack up in New England. And for $40, Michael got the horse, two ducks, and a goat. Yeah, well, this horse is house trained. He goes in their house with them, does whatever the heck he wants. We think he's about 33 now. We're not really sure. He's on a no carrot regime because he's, you know, getting up there and been having some issues. He still gets ginger snaps from his mom. Don't think he's horribly put upon.
Can we run out there and jump on his back?
No. Kid Stormwo tried that once and he wouldn't even move for him.
Yeah. Oh, just
guys won three Kentucky Derbies and he didn't get the mini to move.
That's funny.
So, one time when Michael had Angie Dickinson here staying, because she was speaking at some policewoman's conference in Lexington, y'all remember who Angie Dickinson is? Okay, just checking. She was staying in the house, so Michael thought it'd be real funny. He went in the house, took a little Silver Charm in, and left him in the living room and left. Says a little while later, he gets a phone call from Angie. Michael, there's a horse in your house. Says, oh, I don't mind him. He comes in, watches Al Roker do the weather, and lets himself out. That's Michael, and just summing up what kind of personality this man has to a T. But yeah, that's our little Silver Charm, our little guy. He's still shedding out his winter coat a bit, but he's definitely got some dapples underneath there. But let's go see one of the Derby winners. The one you can get your picture with. Maybe if you can get your cooperation. that's the big gift. That's our cemetery over there to the right. We are a final home for these horses. So they don't really ever leave us. Oh, I think himself is going to come up. I have shred for him.
What's his name?
Silver Charm.
Silver Charm.
There's his paddock sign right there. Hey, Charm! Oh, come on, handsome.
I'm busy.
I got some grass here.
I'm busy.
Hey, Silver Charm. Yes.
What year did he win the Derby?
He's the winner of the 1997 Kentucky Derby and Preakness. He should have been a Triple Crown winner, but he's kind of lazy. Well, his running style was he liked to just eyeball the competition and ding-dong fight it out. As soon as he put someone away, he'd ease up and wait for the competition to come. Well, in the Belmont, the guy riding Touch Gold, Chris McCarron, knew that. So while he was, watch behind you, there's a bucket. I don't want you to trip over the bucket.
Thank you.
So they were he ding-donged it out with his competition free house, put him away, and here comes Touch Gold flying down the middle of the track at the last minute. And he caught him. Once he saw him, he started running hard again, but it was too late. Now, he may not have held off Touch Gold anyway, but, you know, he lost the Triple Crown by 3/4 of a length. Wow. And at the time, I think Bob Baffert thought, darn, this is my only chance at winning the Triple Crown.
Yeah.
And, of course, the next year, his horse, Real Quiet, got beaten about 4 inches for the Triple Crown. And then he saw, okay, that's it. And then a few years later, War Emblem stumbled at the start. He said, okay, that's it. Now he's trained the last two Triple Crown winners.
I think we should hold him some carrots.
Hey, Charles. Oh, he's peeing.
Uh-oh.
That looks like a peace stance, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Yep.
First things first.
Come on.
Hey, Charm.
Come here.
He's 25 years old. Now, he recently had dental surgery. He was starting to have some gum disease and stuff, so he's got 2 front teeth left, and that's it. But he's usually pretty good. If he'll come up here, he will stand and let you give him a handful of these shreds and then get your picture with him and selfie. He's real good about that. He can't eat the big pieces. He has no teeth left. I've got these shreds here. Hey, Charm, are you going to get up here today? Hey, handsome. He also won the Dubai World Cup, so he's traveled. He spent several years in Japan as a stallion. But he,
okay, he's busy. He
says, no,
busy.
I got to poop, too. I've just got to get all my...
Well, he's old.
He's an old man. We had his 25th birthday party here and had quite a few people come out to see him. But if y'all want to do a picture with him, he doesn't like to be petted. Silver Charm gets to do whatever Silver Charm wants. But if you want your picture with him, feel free to grab a couple of carrots. Just stand at the fence and he'll like this and he'll put his head over and you can give him carrots. He's a great selfie horse. He'll do this all day long.
All right, hold on.
Is that a pose with the tongue out?
Here, you want me to...
Well, since he doesn't have teeth to hold him in now, that's kind of become his standard. He says, carrots. He says, I'm not standing here for my health.
So hurry up. Next.
He says, I am a prima donna.
Say next. Get your shot in.
There you go. Paul, do you mind taking a picture of me?
Say, get your shot in.
With the champion? You got your...
Yeah, he earned about $6.8 million on the track, so he wasn't a slouch in the earnings. He's kind of obscurely bred from Florida.
Hey, buddy.
What did he cost when they bought him the first time?
I think they paid $85,000 for him as a two-year-old in training.
Thank you.
So, you know, he went on to really bigger and better things. He's the only horse on this farm who comes in every night because, well, he's Silver Charm and he wants to come in. That's just the way Silver Charm is.
Is he bred out here in Kentucky?
No, he's a Florida bred.
Okay.
He's by Silver Buck out of Bonnie's Poker, who was also, Bonnie, who's actually a long-term resident here.
Okay. Is there one specific area of Florida where there's a lot of...
Ocala. The Ocala area is where most of the breeding is done. But it's not every day you get to feed carrots to a Kentucky Derby winner.
No, that's for sure. Right. Good job, champ.
Anyone else want to give him some carrots? Anyone? I don't want you to miss your chance.
Yeah, I'll do it. Well, you take a picture for me?
Yeah, sure.
Not every day you get to see a Derby winner like this.
What year when he won the Derby?
97.
I think Silver Charm
Let me give you some carrots.
I remember how to hold the camera.
It's all about doing things his way, and his way is he gets carrots when we're doing this because, you know, silver charm and all. That's a great thing about digital, isn't it? I remember my old days with film where I was always so worried about not wasting all my film. And
yeah.
What you doing, Charm?
Can you take a picture?
He's so nice. Thank you. But you can stand right up against the fence and he won't. You think he might give you a kiss with his nose on the cheek?
Where do you think?
Just stand right over
here.
Oh,
no, I meant for her. Oh, sorry. Okay.
No, I was just thinking of her. Thank you.
Look at that tongue.
He's funny, though. See how you have a couple of bits in your hand? You think he'd lick them up?
He doesn't care.
There's not enough. Just drop them because he's not going to. He's very smart and very funny about everything, you know?
I wonder if her tongue is canceled.
I guess they did. I see a tour guide with no tour members on it. So anyway, let's go over and see our other dirt.
Oh, awesome. Thank you.
Which horse is
Derby and the Preakness and the Dubai World Cup. So,
which horse is the most recent Derby winner that you have out here?
It'd be War Emblem, who we're going to see in just a couple of minutes.
That was just
2002.
Okay.
Yeah. I know.
And how many colts has he sired?
You know, the funny thing about him, he only sired about 180 foals.
That seems like
that is typical 1 year's worth of foals for most stallions.
Whoa. Oh, really?
You know, 100, 120 for a good horse. He went to Japan at a cost of $17 million. And he bred his first crop of mares, no problem, did what they asked him to do. The next year he said, I'm not interested. So they spent about 10 years trying to convince him to, he just didn't like to be told what to do. Hi, ZZ. What you doing, Pigpen?
He seems like a really big horse.
Yeah, he's kind of average. Hi. What you doing?
Compared to this horse, seems a little smaller.
Yeah, well, he's a little bit built up with the ground there, too. Okay. This is Z Dagger. Feel free to give him a carrot if you want. He's pretty darn nice. He was just kind of a mid-level allowance horse. He was owned by the Zayats, who also owned American Pharoah.
Oh, really?
I guess that's about his claim to fame here. What? But he comes up every summer because his feet don't deal well out in the hard ground of the paddocks. So he comes up every summer, stays here so his feet don't hurt, then he goes out with his herd in the winter. You are such a... Get those shavings out of your head, my goodness. He's a beggar. Anyone want to give him carrots?
You need a carrot.
Don't be shy. Feel
you
free to come right up.
Yeah, you need a carrot.
He's a gelding, so he's pretty nice. They call him Pigpen because he always has the messiest, muckiest stall to clean out every morning. But we'll go see. We'll go see this guy because he's got a buddy. And then we'll see our Derby winner.
So how long have you been doing this?
I don't know, probably about 10 years.
10 years.
I started coming out as a fan, just wanting to get pictures of the horses. And then, it kind of went up from there because I'm a kid in a candy shop. As Michael likes to say, he equates it to being a basketball fan and being able to wake up in the morning and have Larry Bird and Michael Jordan in your backyard. That's what it's like here for a racing fan and these horses. Hi, Supadoop. We can't not come say hi to you and George.
How come these are in the stalls and then the other ones are out?
Well, Charm comes in at night because Charm wants to come in at night. That's the only reason. Now watch behind you because he will reach out and grab you and it doesn't feel good. He's kind of a bad boy.
Oh, he has a partner. Boy.
Yes, this is one of our older stallions. This is Alphabet Soup. The reason he's in during the day, see how white he is? Mm-hmm. That little nose gets red as a button getting sunburned. So he comes in during the day and goes out at night. Just watch behind y'all because he will bite. And he has a long neck. But he's got a buddy here named Gorgeous George. He's real cute. But if you want to get Soup some carrots, feel free to step up. Soupy here won the 1996 Breeders' Cup Classic. Now, if you're a racing fan, you'll realize that was also the last race of a horse named Cigar. So he kind of ruined Cigar's retirement. I know. Retirement party.
Does he have teeth either?
He does, but they're just getting to the point that it hurts to chew. Oh. You give him a little piece of carrot and it'll take him 5 minutes to chew it. So we find the shreds and he's not upset by shreds. But he came to us a few years ago and he's been pensioned here.
That one. Oh,
but his little buddy here, Gorgeous George, belonged to one of the guys who works on the farm, and his dad had passed away. So he brought George here and they just fell in love over the fence. So we finally put him in a paddock together with a pen in there so George couldn't get hurt. And they lay down back to back through the pen.
Looks like this is where the...
Yeah, you gotta be careful with afternoon delights. George can have carrots if you want to put a carrot through the fence for him. He can chew.
So afternoon delights can have carrots?
He can, but it's not nice. See how Soup is very nice and just nosing me?
Yeah.
Bird bites.
Man.
Yeah, he can have little pieces of carrots. So.
Do it again. I missed that shot.
What, me getting bit? Almost getting bit?
Yeah.
You see how good my reflexes were?
Let me tell you.
Man, I was. You trying to throw slobber on us?
I'm
you
sorry, mean. That's everything. Charm made some of the kids.
You were mean. Look at you.
That's afternoon delights over there. Ken Sormo, who's won the Derby 3 times, says this is the fastest horse he ever sat.
Which one?
The one behind you, Mr. Bitey McBitey.
Bitey McBitey, yeah.
He actually goes out in Silver Charms paddock at night because he's on kind of a little
River Squall.
Hello.
Hannibal leather mask on his nose at night to limit his graces and stuff. He ran in the 1995 Kentucky Derby, so that's a 3-year-old kind of body with a big man.
That's good. Yeah, big smile.
But he's still a
snout.
I'm sorry. For years, he was the best looking horse on the farm. And he is pretty nice. He just has his moments. Yes, he just tried to bite my hand. With that.
He's giving me carrots. He's still
Yeah. Like I said, he just has his moments. But he's got a good bod on him. Look at that bod. He'd be a pinup if he was a person. Oh, here, I'd better give River a couple of carrots.
Yeah, I think so. He said he's nice. Yeah,
some surgery done this week, so we're trying to keep him quiet.
Oh,
hopefully that was down.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I just want to walk in here and see the suit. Please don't bite me. I thank you, carrots. Just come around this way. You'll see our other derby winner
who's right
here.
You are.
Oh, excuse me. I'm coming through.
He's going to go over to the fence there. There's no hands on for the next one.
This is War Emblem. There's a double fence.
Yeah, we're not allowed to touch this one.
What?
Why?
I don't know.
Must be a reason.
He's big too. He's really.
That's a big horse.
Yes.
Yeah, I'll be. He's
big. Look at those long legs.
Mm-hmm. He's standing there. He's like, I know I'm a
ball. All right, come on over.
Come on, buddy.
Got some girls to kiss. Come on over. Kiss the girls.
Hey, I brought you some nice long carrots.
Uh-oh.
From my private stash.
We can't go in.
Oh, they can't.
Why are they in quarantine?
He's not really in quarantine, but he will bite. Hey.
Whoa.
He likes to play bite the carrot. Don't you? This is War Emblem. He won the 2002 Kentucky Derby in Preakness. He stumbled at the start of the Belmont, so he didn't become a Triple Crown winner either. He also won the Haskell later that year, which is a big three-year-old race. And then according to Bob Baffert, he just decided he didn't want to race anymore. He pretty much quit putting anything out, training or anything. So he was sold to Japan for $17 million. They thought he was going to be their next great stallion. And he did his first book of mares, no problem. Did what he was supposed to do. The next year, he refused to cover mares. Showed zero interest in doing his job. And he, they tried for years. They put him out in a paddock full of mares. They would parade mare after mare by him, seeing if anyone caught his attention. You know, anything they could to try to get mares covered. And he produced one champion, and I think 80% of his foals who raced were winners. That's one heck of a good strike rate. You don't see horses get 80% winners from starters, unless they've only had like two foals and they both win or something. Hey, would you like to show them how you race? It doesn't look too muddy out today. You want to race or not?
About how much does that horse weigh?
Probably about 1,000 to 1,100 pounds.
Yeah. He's still a stallion.
You're gonna run back.
You're not gonna race, so you're just. Nope, he's not racing today. Sometimes he'll come running down and won't you war him one? Today's just not one of those days. He doesn't like to be pet at all. You notice I'm not trying to sneak in pets or anything, because he just doesn't like it. One of the smartest horses I know, he will pretty much do what he wants, when he wants, how he wants, where he wants. He, when he came back, the government requires every stallion coming back to be test bred twice to make sure he didn't have any communicable diseases. He wasn't going to listen to the government either. He refused. It has to be a live cover. That's the law. So it's not like we can just take a sample and go, oh, look, he's okay. So he was gelded.
Oh.
So he's actually a gelding. It hasn't changed his disposition whatsoever.
That'll teach him.
Yeah, right. So I'm not peeing in the cup. Yeah, what you say?
But isn't he gorgeous? He's just absolutely gorgeous.
Yeah.
This is the only way I can pet him. Is if he's got his face in the bucket and teeth otherwise occupied. It's interesting. Just so you know. Other people signed up on her tour who said they needed a golf cart.
This is Roosevelt. We're out here at the Old Friend Thoroughbred Horse Farm. Ooh, can't even talk this morning. Louisville, Kentucky. Just had a nice presentation, some history of the horses that are boarded here. Later on, we're going to go to Churchill Downs. Right now, we're just touring the Old Friends Thoroughbred Horse Farm. This is a part of the Toyota Bluegrass Tour. I want to thank Toyota for the invite. It's been a very, very informative day, especially yesterday at the plant. I mean, we were inundated with so much information. We got to meet the president of manufacturing. Had a one-on-one conversation with her. I'll put that video up later this weekend. But you can check us out at autonetwork.com. Or on Facebook. Right now we're live streaming from the Old Friends Thoroughbred Horse Farm, Louisville, Kentucky.
Bye.
Do you have any favorites?
Dad's not going to make me.
Me here?
Yeah.
You know, I did. I had a mare that I really loved who died this winter, so I haven't really picked back up a new one because it's hard.
Oh, no.
Oh, someone's having a roll. That's the dude getting muddy.
Oh, getting muddy. Playing in the
Yeah. There's a few old geldings up back I'm kind of fond of, but we haven't quite built the relationship yet, so who knows if it'll click or not. Look at that. He said, Mikey was muddy. I have to get muddy, too.
Oh, you got it.
Hi, dude. That and he keeps flies from biting.
Right.
We go groom them and take off all their fly prep, and then they're going. You're muddy now. Hi, Mikey. We're actually going to say hi to these guys because we already haven't seen them yet. Now how I mentioned these two horses never won a championship and Eclipse Award. This paddock next door, both of them have Eclipse Awards. Watch out, he can be a bit tough at times.
Are you a tough one?
He would like some carrots though, so. So I think he's back on carrots. That's a championship, year in championship, okay. The Eclipse Awards. This is Amazombie. He was a champion sprinter.
Amazombie.
He was one of those sprinters who fall way back behind the other horses and then in the stretch come flying out of the clouds.
Oh, wow.
So he had quite a closing kick on him. So he won an Eclipse Award as champion sprinter. He also won the Breeders' Cup sprint, didn't you, Zombie?
Zombie.
The horse out there who's ignoring us, that's Rapid Redux. He never won a stakes race, but he's got an Eclipse Award, too. He won an Eclipse Award of Merit after he ran 22 consecutive victories.
Wow.
Lower level, starter allowance, optional claimers, but still, 22 in a row, no matter what level you're at.
That's incredible.
That's something that you... Hey, Zombie! Like I said, he can be snappy.
Like, give me those carrots.
I think you're supposed to have carrots. He had caught a colic episode recently, so he was off carrots for a while, but I think we're back on.
But so there's a vet on staff?
He's another cribber.
There's a vet on staff here?
Not on staff, but we do have a vet who pretty much donates all his services, and the other clinics, when we have to call them in, they give us discounts, right. So. But...
Down here too. We'll see the horse who stole more emblems for the crown. It's warm enough, I think this will be nice small. Cold weather Saraba comes at you with his teeth bare. Oh, Rapid, did you decide to sneak down past the lawn?
They recognize that green bucket? Is that what it is?
They know there's carrots coming. He's got a bad ankle. If you look at that right front ankle, see how much bigger it is?
Yeah,
that's just wear and tear from his racing career. And Zombie's kind of a butthead, so he doesn't want to get run off by Zombie because it hurts. But he does like to get carrots. He just, you know, horses are smart. He noticed Zombie was otherwise occupied, so he came down here to grab a few carrots. He's smart, you know? Gotta give horses credit for knowing when they can get away with stuff and when they can't. Cardinal.
Yeah.
Pretty red cardinal. Well, you know, male. Gosh, the Rob is even talking. Look at these paddocks. I think
now,
I
this is
the
Derby winner as well?
No, he's a Belmont Stakes winner.
Belmont.
Which today is Belmont Stakes Day,
yeah,
so he's a
fact,
special.
We're watch
watch
that.
Out, he can bite, so.
We're going to watch that today.
Hi, Saravas. He'll pick carrots.
All right, I'll be one.
Yeah.
The rest of them.
He's
I
a
might
stallion.
As well
he's a nice big old stud for us. Oh, look at Mike and Dude. They are so funny when they start playing. Mike just had a roll. Now they're going to. Yep, there goes Mikey. Horses in action. Mikey and the Dude. Feel free to give him a carrot, though.
Ted, do you want me to take your picture or anything?
Sure. Yeah, he can be a bit nippy, so I wouldn't get too awfully close. Okay. Well, already, if you have a carrot.
I already got me my share of nips.
Okay.
I know, I couldn't help myself, sorry.
Just watch out. Yeah, like I said, he's my horse. I would step away because he's going to bite.
Really?
When he used to be over there, first horse on tours, he was my demonstration horse. When I said horses can bite and will bite and it can hurt, he's my demo horse. What can I say? Sirrah is such a good teacher, aren't you? Hi, buddy. He won the Belmont Stakes in 2002 at odds of 70-1.
Wow.
That was his one big hurrah as a racehorse. Yes, it was. Yeah. He started his racing career in England and then came over to the U.S. because they thought he might run better on the dirt. His breeding, he was by Wild again, so that was a dirt horse, not a turf horse pedigree.
Is it all turf in the UK?
Yeah, they do have some synthetic races for lower level horses in the winter, but it's pretty much all turf.
Okay.
Most of the rest of the world is pretty much all turf. Watch out behind you, there's a horse coming in.
And that's a shorter track, right? It's on the inner ring, I guess?
No, in England, the horses, the tracks are these big sprawling turf things.
Oh, really?
It's okay. Here in the US where the turf is a tiny little afterthought at most tracks.
Yeah, it's the inner ring, so it's less than...
It's tighter, well, 7/8 or more. Yeah, okay. It's just tighter turns, and it's just not as conducive. Plus, our tracks are a lot harder.
You came all the way over here. You should get a treat.
I mean, I spent a lot of time in France. I'm doing 3 trips to France this year to go racing. And it's just a whole different world out there.
Really? Yeah. And they run the other
sometimes straight. They'll go 5/8 of a mile straight. They have one race that's 1.25 miles straight.
Straight, really?
At Newmarket. Yeah.
You either see the start or the end, but not much else.
Right, right. But anyway, this is our first, he was the first classic winner to come to the farm. So he's always going to have a special place because, yeah, we've got Silver Charm and War Emblem now, but he was the first. And when you get the first, that's something. Yeah, and you know his foals he was siring, they were pluggers. They could just run all day, but you know, no one wanted to buy horses who could run all day because that's not the American thing. We want speed, 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 and then some more speed. Right? Yeah, and really, when we started the Breeders' Cup Marathon, we ran it 1.5 miles, and Europeans laughed at us. Because to them, a marathon or stayers race is a minimum of 2 miles. 1.5 miles is what they call middle distance in Europe.
It seems like a lot of physical exertion for the horse.
Well, you know, really, I think in a way, the longer races are easier on the horses.
Really?
Well, because think about it. They're not going to be running as fast. The sprints, they have to go all out.
This is Roosevelt Lovato Network. We're here at the old Friends Thoroughbred Horse Farm. And a nice presentation about the horses that are here, how they got here. There's actually a horse cemetery where the horses are buried here, but a lot of the Derby winners and other well-known race winners retire here. And I'm going to end the presentation now. It's been about, maybe almost an hour. Thank you for tuning in. This is a part of the Toyota Bluegrass Tour here in Louisville. And as always, please buckle up. Don't drink and drive. Buckle up, don't text and drive. Buckle up, don't stream and drive. See you next time.
Come by.